Welcome dear students. As usual, you must be fine. I am fine too. Now, you may wonder how confidently I say you are fine. You know why? Because the students who study regularly are always fine, happy and smart. Though I can't see you, I am sure you look like happy and smart students. Wow! The phrase look like reminded me of a joke which will take us to today's topic. Don mitra astat, Raju and Sanju. Raju Sanju la vicharto, mi murkha sarka disto ka? Sanju manto nahi. Mag mi vedya sarka disto ka? Sanju manto nahi. Majhe dole kavya sarke ahet ka? Sanju manto nahi re. Pan tu asa ka vichartos? Raju manto, मग मला सगळे असे का म्हणतात की मी तुझ्यासारखा दिसतोय. पाहिलं मित्रांनो, राजू संजूला थोडक्यात असंही म्हणू शकला असता की नाही, तू मूर्ख, वेडा आणि कावळ्यासारखे डोळे असलेला दिसतोस. याला समरी म्हणतात. राजू कुड हॅव सेड, संजू यू लुक लाईक अ स्टुपिड मॅड अँड क्रो आयड बॉय. धिस इज कॉल्ड समरी. सो कम ऑन,
let's learn summary writing. Summary means to sum up the passage in a few words. It means a short retelling of the long passage.
Friends, summary writing is an important skill you have to develop. Remember the things I tell you. Before writing, read the passage carefully. Focus on what the writer is saying. Find the main ideas, leave out the minor details. Sometimes your parents scold you for not studying and give you 5 to 10 minutes lecture. But you understand the main idea that they want you to study regularly and you leave out the minor details which aren't essential. This is the summary. After reading the passage, write a suitable title. Write as if you are telling to your friend. Write in your own words. Keep the same meaning of the original passage. Use a few words in a simple language. Write in a sequence. Friends, after watching a movie, you tell a story to your friends. And that in your own words. 3 hours movie, but you tell a story in 15 minutes. This is called summary. While writing summary, don't write examples, illustrations, comments and evidences that the writer has given. Don't write your own examples and opinions. Don't repeat the points. Don't go beyond main points. Now, let's read a passage and write its summary.
For the student, walking is preferable to all other exercises. The advantages of this mode of exercise are that it is simple, the apparatus is all at hand and complete. You need not wait for any great machinery. It is done in the open air so that the lungs can at once receive the pure air of heaven and the eye gaze upon the hill or dale, upon trees and flowers, upon objects inanimate and animate. The variety of objects appeal to sight and sound, cheer the mind and raise the spirit. Another advantage of walking is that you can have a friend to walk with and add to your pleasure by having a cheerful conversation. If you once try the exercise of walking with a friend regularly for a few weeks, you will be surprised at the results.
I read the passage carefully. I found the main idea, the advantages of walking. So I gave the title, The Advantages of Walking. While writing, we can remove the examples of natural things. And we can write the summary of the same passage this way.
The Advantages of Walking. Walking is the best exercise for the students. It's simple, healthy and needs no apparatus. Natural beauty brings joy to both the eye and the mind. A friend makes walking more cheerful by his talk. Regular walks surely give surprising results.
Friends, you learnt now how simple and interesting summary writing is. Then start writing summary of the lesson you learn, the news you read, and the movie you watch. Bye. See you in the next period.